everybody. Here we are. So, as we all know, we're gathered here this afternoon to celebrate and commemorate one of the greatest songwriters in the history of human beings, an iconic Canadian, a man who really needs no contextualization whatsoever. He is simply a part of the fabric of this country and our culture and our music. And we have assembled a murderer's row of iconic Atlantic Canadian and national musicians behind me here to celebrate this great man, Mr. Gordon Lightfoot, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure everybody present here today, from every generation and every corner of the country, has a distinct connection to Gordon Lightfoot's music. It's been the soundtrack of our life here in this country, and we're going to celebrate it right now. So without any further ado, we're going to kick off straight away with one of the champions of Standfest, one of our favorites, and after last night's tweener shall henceforth be known, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Judd Gunning's dad.
That's awesome. So I was lucky to meet Lightfoot a few times, but the first time I was with JP, we were on the Stomp and Tom Connors tour and playing at Rideau Hall, and JP and I were getting a coffee and didn't realize he was standing right in front of us in the lineup, and he had his silver sneakers on. I said, "I think that's Lightfoot right in front of us." And JP said, "It is." And we didn't have the guts to kind of meet him at that moment, but after, it was the only show that I didn't play upright bass on. I played electric bass on that show because they sent cabs to pick us up instead of vans. And I said, "Tom, I can't fit the upright in the cabs, so I have to take the electric." And Tom said, "That's okay, boy. We're only doing three songs anyway. Take the electric bass, we'll be fine." So I packed up, at the end of the three songs, I packed up the electric bass, and I'm walking through the curtain, and this thin little curtain blowing in the wind and stuff, and Bare Naked Ladies were coming on, Natalie McMaster was coming on, Paul Brandt was at that, and we're walking through the curtain, and I nailed a guy really hard in the inner leg with my electric bass guitar, really hard, smoked, bang, and it was Gordon Lightfoot. And I said, "You're my favorite," and And he said, "Oh, yeah." I said, "Sorry, sorry." He goes, "No, no problem. Great groove for the last minute." He'd only watched the last minute of the show. Anyway, here's the Lightfoot tune. A song called "Go My Way." If you know the words, sing it along so I can read your lips. I tried to pick one I didn't know that well. Go my way and I'll be good to you. Go my way and your dreams will all come true. In the wild waves are calling, my shadow falls over you. Go my way and I'll take you by the hand. Believe in me and I'll do the best I can. I can't be anything but just what I am. I can't help it if I'm in love with you. Why must I sail my ship alone without a friend? My thoughts are of you, I dare not ask again. Go my way, it's the only way to go. If things aren't working out, you'll be the first to know. Come on along and together we'll go. Please love me, say that you'll be mine. Why must I sail my ship alone without a friend? My thoughts are of you, I dare not ask again. Go my way, it's the only way to go. If things aren't working out, you'll be the first to know. Come on along and together we'll go. Please love me, say that you'll be mine. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, boys.
I can't believe I have to follow that.
You'll be just fine, Joe.
You're an absolute treasure, Dave. An absolute treasure. I can't even begin to tell you all how honored I am to be on this stage with these fine musicians. It's really something else, celebrating somebody that was so iconic. And I just, I'm so happy I get to share this moment with all of you out there and all these wonderful people up here. The song that I got here was something that resounded with me so, so deeply the first time that I heard it, that I just never even bothered to try and touch it. I just sat and listened as a fan. One's the house that you live in. First in the world, go forth with your fears, aware of dangers below. Always too soon, never too fast, a time when all bets must be laid. Beware of the darkness, be kind to your children, remember the woman who waits. And the house you live in will never fall down, if you pity the stranger stands at your gate. You're caught by the gale, you're full under sail, beware of the dangers below. The song that you sing should not be too sad, and be sure not to sing it too slow. Be calm in the face of all common disgraces, and know what they're doing it for. And the house you live in will never fall down, if you pity the stranger stands at your door. When you're out on the road, feeling quite lost, remember the burdens of fame. Where they say to fail when other men fail at the game. Beware of strange faces and dark, dingy places, and the place it is a bullshit. The house you live in will never fall down, if you pity the stranger stands at the door. When you're down in the dumps, not ready to deal, decide what it is that you need. Is it money or love, the mouths to live, or is it the mouths you must feed? Known as a man who'll always be candid on questions that do not relate. And the house you live in will never fall down, if you pity the stranger stands at the gate. And the house you live in will never fall down, if you pity the stranger stands at the gate.
Thank you all so very kindly.
Joe H. Henry.
Check 1, 2.
Can't believe I fucked it up.
Happens to the best of us.
Sorry, folks. I missed my cue. Very unprofessional of me. That was Joe Henry. Who I am late to the party on, as they say. I've just met Joe this weekend, and I'm absolutely blown away, dude. It's outstanding. I've named Joe the Towns Van Zandt of Nova Scotia, because I think he's pretty damn cool. So from one Nova Scotia legend to another, folks, our next performer is no stranger to this festival. He's a fellow Cape Bretoner. He is an icon on our island. He has been tied to some of the most successful musical acts in the history of our island. He is a first call bass player across this entire country. He's played with everybody, including our namesake, Stan Rogers. He is a wonderful, wonderful Cape Breton fiddle player. I've had the pleasure of working with this man numerous times. He's one of my favorites. He plays a ton of Gordon Lightfoot's music in his own shows, so he's got a bag of tricks here he's going to blow us away with. No pressure. Ladies and gentlemen, my good friend and wonderful, wonderful musician, Mr. Ali Bennett.
Thank you. Thanks, Kelly. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you. Yeah, I got to meet Mr. Lightfoot a few times over the years, and the song I'm going to do, he had great success with in 1976. But it didn't come easy for him, you see. This is a 6.5-minute story song, and his record company did not want him to release this song as a single to radio, because back in the 70s, if your song was longer than 3 minutes, you just didn't get on the radio, you see. That was too much time between commercials to a radio programmer back in those days. But he persevered, he argued long and hard. Finally, the record company backed down. They allowed him to release it as a single in its entirety. A little side story here. I heard an interview with Don Henley of the Eagles a while back, and at that time, in 1976, the Eagles were sitting on a song that was 6.5 minutes long, just wondering whether to release it to radio or not. When they saw the success of this next song, they went ahead and released Hotel California. So. So this song here is an historical account of the tragic events that occurred on Lake Superior on November 10th, 1975. On from the Chippewa on down of the big lake they call Gitchigoobie. Lake, it is said, never gives up for dead when the gales of November come early. With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. That good ship and true was a bone to be chewed when the gales of November came early. The ship was a pride to the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned. Concluding some terms with a couple of steel firms when she left fully loaded for Cleveland. Later that night when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they've been feeling? The wind and the wires made a tattletale sound, and a wave broke over the Raven. Every man knew, as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. When afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. When supper time came, the old cook came on deck, saying, fellas, it's too rough to feed you. At 7 p.m. it grew dark, it was then he said, fellas, it's been good to know ya. The captain wired in, he had water coming in, and the good ship and crew were in peril. Later that night, when his lights went out of sight, came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn the minutes to hours? Searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay if they'd put 15 more miles behind her. They might have split up or they might have capsized. They may have broke deep and took water. And all that remains is the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. Lake Huron rolls, Superior sings in the rooms of her ice water mansions. Michigan streams like a young man's dreams. The islands and bays are for sportsmen. And farther below, Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. And the iron boats go, as the mariners all know, with the gales of November, remember. In a rustic old hall in Detroit, they prayed in the Maritime Sailors' Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa down of the big lake they call Gitche-Gumee. Superior, they said, never gives supper dead when the gales of November come early.